Howdy, it's your girl. What's up? So today I'm going to show you how to make this key charm. Purse charm, key charm, whatever you want to call it. Some people I think call it key fob. But I was actually asked to show if I would show how to create this. So the things you're going to need is you're going to need your fabric. You're going to need one or whatever type of ring. This is one that you actually can put on your keychain. And then this one you can just actually hook to something. So I think we're going to use that one. You're going to need your fabric glue, because I said this was a no sew project, but you are going to need a needle and thread. It's just a no sewing machine project. Okay. This one I actually did use a sewing machine for, but for this particular project, we're not going to do that, okay? So we're going to do a no sew, because this is for people who want to know about no sew, okay? You're going to need something round. This is like a 2-inch square, I believe. I think it's 2. And I got this from either Michael's or Joann's. I'm not sure. But I know Michael's had these. Joann's have them too. But, or either you can use a piece of cardboard, something that you already have, make a circle. Don't go any bigger or any larger than a 2-inch. It's up to you, but right now we're going to work with the key fob, so I would like to stay at this size, or you can do a 1-inch, 1.5, 2-inch. All right, so of course you're going to need your scissors, and you're going to need a needle and thread, okay? So here's mine, okay? So the first thing we're going to do, you're going to need a pen. Let's not forget the pen. So let's slide all this stuff out of the way. So the first thing I want you to do, now this is actually a fat quarter of fabric. So the first thing you're going to do is, I always iron out my fabric and make sure that all the wrinkles is out. That's just me. That's what I do. So you're going to take your fabric, and we're going to mark it on the wrong side. I need a little more room on this table. I got stuff everywhere. And what you're going to do is you're going to create 5 of these, okay? Now, if you want to make 2, since we're going to make 2, because we have 2 on the charm, so since we're going to make 2, what I do is I fold my fabric over, and we're going to make 10. And we should be able to make 10 out of this. So let me show you how you do it. So you fold it over like this. Put your circle down. You're going to take it, your pen, or I'm using a pen, you're going to mark around. Oh, make sure you have some straight pens as well, okay? So that's going to be 1 circle, 2 circles. Then you're going to put it here. Remember, we need 10 because we're making 2. You can make it close because you're going to cut it anyway, so. And there we go. Okay, so now, after I have drawn the circles, the next thing that I do is I take pins and I pin this together like this on both layers. And the reason that I do that is that when I cut it, I want them to stay together. Okay. I want the fabric to stay together as I cut. Okay. So then I take my scissors and I just cut here, across here first. Make it a little easier for me. Okay. the next thing I will do. And you'll find your own method of cutting once you start. But I cut them each apart like this. Okay, so now I take my scissors, I'm going to cut around the circle that I created. And you repeat this process with all of your circles or pieces of fabric. Cut out all your circles. Now, I'm going to also create, this is a real-time video. I'm creating a real-time video, and I'm going to also create a faster video for those who are in a hurry. At least I'm thinking about it, okay? Sometimes we just need to slow down and relax. This really relaxes me. I've been working on a lot of stuff lately, so. I've been working on frames. I've just been working on some stuff, so. I'm really trying to get these DIYs out for you all. Schedule's kind of slowed down a little bit now, so I'm able to actually do a little more DIYs. I have a lot of requests, so I'm gonna get them in as much as I can. So just bear with me, be patient, and thank you so much for subscribing to the channel. I really appreciate that. I'm glad you all like my work, and you know, that just really, you know, and people really care for real, and you know, it's like, you don't mind doing videos, so I'm excited about it, and thank you so much for that. Okay, so now, see, that didn't go, that went quick, but that's talking. So now what you're going to do is you're going to take all of them loose, okay? Take your pins out and just do them like this for the next step. Our next step is a fun step, I think so anyway. And you're going to actually need two more pieces of fabric as well. So you can, two pieces of small fabric, which is going to go in the middle of each of these. And actually, I have a couple that I had cut out. So what I'm going to do is make these just a little smaller. You can just take a piece of fabric yourself and make a smaller circle. And that's what I'm going to do with these couple of pieces of fabric. They were a little large, so I'm just going to make them just smaller. And this is the piece that goes actually in the middle of the flower that we're going to create. Okay. So now that we've done that, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take our flower. And this is how we get started in making a flower. We're going to have five petals on each flower. Okay. So you take five pieces of your fabric. Let's see, 3, 4, 5. Okay, because we make it two flowers, okay? So now we're gonna take it, and then you're going to turn it over. You're going to fold it in half, wrong sides together. Then you're going to take it, and you're going to fold it in half again. And you see where the ends meet here? That's where you're gonna start to stitch at, all right? So just follow me and what I'm doing. So take your needle and thread. I already knotted it at the end. And we're going to start in the, I'm going to start it here. Okay. I'm going to start that in the inside just to put that little piece of thread in there. Okay. So we're going to start here in the back. Okay. And we're going to go in and we're going to go in and out. In here. And out, which is a weaving process, okay, with the needle and thread. You're going to pull it out. Let's see if we can get it out. This is a little needle, so, oops, voila. it's a little needle, but no, just take your time. See, there you go, and you're gonna pull it, and you're gonna pull them together, and that's what's gonna make the flower. So you'll see. Back in, out, here we go. And you're just gonna repeat this process. I'd be so glad when I can get my sewing room in the lower level of the house, because you can hear everything that happens outside. And all of a sudden, I promise you, when nobody's been saying nothing all day, now everybody's outside. So that was the first one. You see how we did that? So then we're going to start the second one. We do the same thing. We fold it in half. Then you fold it over like that. And then you have this little cone shape kind of thing, I guess you could say. And then we're going to start on this side again with our thread. We're going to add this to the first flower, with the first flower, weaving in and out with our needle and thread. And we're going to keep on doing that until we have created, put all five petals together. Okay? Let's see. Okay? And you'll see. Ooh, come on. It's a little time consuming, but you know, it makes a nice flower. See, we already got two, so now let's go fold it over. And take it and fold it again. And we're going to always start at the open side of it. That's where we start stitching at, okay? Okay. And you can always, if you, you know, if you don't have time to make the little embellish. Ouch. Ooh. La. Got stuck myself. That hurt, no blood. But if you don't have time to create your embellishments, you can always go to Michael's or any fabric store, Joann's or whatever. You can always buy, they have stuff, and you can look online and find little flower embellishments if you like, you know, and create it like that. They always have little flowers and stuff. So, but I just think that this is a little creative because you actually putting the time in making your own thing, so it's more personalized, you know. So we got three. So we fold it in half, fold it again. See, they just out there doing all kinds of stuff. Let me dare you. I will be so glad. Now see, that ain't even necessary. I don't know if y'all can hear that, but that's just ridiculous. I'm telling you, nobody been out there all day. So, you know, I'm going to start doing my videos early, early in the morning when nobody gets, when everybody is asleep or everybody is at school, you know. Because you can hear they out there dropping pipes and doing all kinds of stuff. Like, that's why I really want to take my sewing room in the basement. So, anyway, my sewing studio, rather, in the basement. Need more room anyway, because I have so much stuff, y'all, that, because I used to teach after school program, and I'm actually looking to start teaching a sewing program to young people, young school age children. I'm looking at doing a sewing, piece of thread got caught, a sewing, some sewing classes for them to teach. Remember when we had home making and the guys had wood shop when we were in school? Anybody remember that? Okay, I'm not trying to date y'all, age y'all, but remember that? I mean, just none of that stuff is happening anymore. But we were doing, my sister still does after school program. We were doing an after school program and teaching that And now I'm kind of pushing teaching the sewing piece, but if not, I want to, basically I would like to open up a school. Not a school, but just take my studio on the road and take my studio on the road and teach young kids fashion design and basically sewing with STEM. So I'm excited about that. That's one of the things that I've been working on. So yeah, it's gonna be cool. So I said, well, and I'm working on some fundraising items actually now, but some little art pieces that I do. I shared with you one day. But right now, let's get back to this. So yep, you just keep on doing this until you have five pieces of stems for your flower. And you just keep adding it to the thread, the same piece of thread. And sometimes it get caught under and just pull it out. Okay, so here we have it. So now that we have this all together, our next step is putting it, our next step is pulling it tight and putting it together like this. I'm sorry, I hope my hands wasn't out of the screen. I was just pulling it together tight. So one of the ways you can do it, and you hold it tight. Sometimes you could just hold it tight and do it right there before you put it together. And I'll show you. Hold on. See, I told you it's a little time consuming, but it's relaxing. If you're not doing nothing, looking at a movie, watch a movie and wanna sew or something, you know. So what I'm gonna do is you pull it. Make sure the thread is tight. I usually hold it, trying to get that down. Here we go. And then I take my, go in two or three. While it's tight. And you'll find your own method for tightening this as well. I don't know, I think my needle is a little bit too small. It's one of those needles that you can actually pop the thread on. So anyway. So here we go. Yeah. Come on. Just keep it tight and pull it. There you go. All right, so now what you're going to do, now that you have done that, put it on here. And like I said, you will find your own way of doing this, okay? As you make these, you will find your own way. Depends. Sometimes I make it a little different than that. So now we're going to put these two together, because that's what you want to do now. You want to take this piece and you want to put it together with this piece. So what I do is just take it like this, take this piece like this, and just take my needle through and pull it together. Trying to see what my little piece of thread. Sometimes it don't want to pull all the way through. Just pull it through. There you go. See? And it's not hard. Like I said, once you get it, you'll get it. Okay? You just have to start doing it. So Then I'll take it and just keep on sewing them together to close it up. Okay. Then I'm going to show you the step two to this flower. That is two steps. Now, you can use fabric glue, you can use hot glue gun, whatever you want to use, okay? This is the step one. This is the part, okay? You can turn it over, see which side you like the best, okay? I think I like this side the best. You try to get it as tight as you can, okay? And that's how it is, like that. That's nice, see? So the next thing we're going to do is make that middle piece. And I made one here, okay, and I made this little middle piece. And that's when I told you we cut a piece of fabric that was a lot smaller than this. So I cut a little small piece of fabric. And you can do this one or two ways too. What I did was, I'm tying my knot, y'all, putting a knot in the thread. What I did, hopefully this is not big. Sometimes I stuff them after I make them for the middle. I might stuff it with a little bit of the pillow stuffing, but it depends. So now what you're gonna do is take your, and sometimes I just put it on flat like I did this one, okay? And I like using, actually you can use your fabric glue with this or you can use your glue gun. Which I really like using my glue gun, and believe it or not, it holds really well. You know, it doesn't come all loose or nothing. So I'm gonna actually fire up the glue gun for this piece, okay? So if you have one, fire up your glue gun, or you can use fabric glue, whatever you have. Let me get my glue gun going. Cause by the time I get finished with that, I can, excuse me. Okay, so I fired up my glue gun. Okay, so now you take this piece of fabric and we're going to start. I always put the little knot in the inside of it, in the back. So we're going to actually do the same thing except for we're not folding it. And we just go around like this. We're going to create a little round piece of, like a little round circle, like a bug. Go in the middle, you know. You'll see, just keep on doing just like this. In and out, just like we did the other one, except for we didn't fold it. And this is for our middle piece. Now, some people put buttons. You can put buttons there if you like. You can put a button there. You can do whatever you want to do with this, okay? Make it your own design. Create however you want to create it. And I think you'll be fine. And I use these for my wallets that I make, which I'm going to have a tutorial coming up with the wallets that I make. Someone did ask me to show that. So wallets and key fobs, if you make stuff for headbands, you can actually put little pins on here and make a little pin. Jewelry piece, you know, so it's up to you. You have to learn how to just get creative with what you do, you know. Do what you do. Yeah, so here we go. So after I close it off, I'm sorry, I pulled it together. And now I'm just putting this piece of thread. I'm just taking this through to knot it off. And I pulled it to close up the I think it's this needle that I'm using, y'all. I think it's the needle. I think it's a little too maybe small for what I'm doing. I don't know. Anyway, so see, pull it together and you're gonna create this little piece here. And okay, let's do it one more time. Take it through. Pull it and cut. Alright. So now you have the little piece, like a little hat, right? And you have a little piece that you're gonna stick right here. And like I said, some people use buttons at this point. sometimes I stuff them like this one. You see how it's sticking up? I stuffed it. Just make it stick up. But this is fine. So the next thing I'm going to do is take my glue gun, and I'll show you that in a minute. Let's see, it should be hot by now. And you take it and you put a little glue on here. Make sure you have enough, because you want it to stick to the fabric. You take it and then put it on there. Let me take a little piece of fabric, because I didn't have because you had to open it in the back. So let me take something to help me push this down. But you have a little opening in the back. And actually, you could actually put a little piece of fabric back there if you like. But see, and that's what you have. How nice. Isn't that nice? And you can use those for anything that you want to use them for. The fobs and everything, okay? So now, I'm going to do one more, because we're doing it for the fob. Now, actually, you could do a one. You could do a one flower fob, too. I mean, keep chain thing, you could do put one flower on there. So for this sake, I'm gonna do one for this, and I'm gonna do one for something else, and I'll show you. Okay, so let's make another one. Let's do one more. Okay, I'm gonna put my glue gun back on. Oh, I guess I need to just kind of put it up here with me, and then I don't have to keep on reaching down on the ground for it. Okay, so let's do this again. So we're going to take our needle and thread. So make sure that you have enough thread on there. So I'm going to re-thread my needle. I can't believe I look like my battery is getting ready to die. And I just charged that battery, so that is really weird. Okay, that's how it go. All right, hey everybody. We're back. Oh my goodness. I told you how my... that my battery, I don't know, it just went dead. Wow, I thought I just had charged it. So we're getting ready to actually do part two of our video. And part two of the video is actually putting the key fob together, or keychain, whatever you want to call it. So what I did, I went ahead and I made a few more embellishments. This is the one I showed you how to do. If you watch the video, I think that you can easily pick up on that, how we made the flowers. If not, if you want me to do another one, or just continue, if you just go back and keep looking at it, you know, you'll figure it out. So I made a few more, and I'll show you what we're going to do with those. But for right now, I'm going to show you how I did the key fob. So what I did, I cut a piece of fabric, and remember, this is a no-sew project, except for needle and thread, so it's not using a sewing machine. So what I did was I cut a piece of fabric, and this piece of fabric, actually, the measurements will be in the description box. So you can look in the description box, because a lot of people always ask me, you know, again, even if I mention it, they'll always ask, what's the measurement? So what I'm going to do is put it in the description box, so that you can always refer back to the description box. And also, I'll have a link to my website as well, okay, with the information. If you can't find something, I'll have information on my website as well. Okay, so, which is, of course, angiebstyle.com. So now, so you're going to cut your fabric, and once you cut your fabric, again, measurements in the description box, okay? What you're going to do is you're going to fold it over. You're going to fold it in half. You're going to press it in half, okay? Then you're going to open it back up, and you're going to take the side, bring it to the middle, then bring the other side, and it's going to touch in the middle. And then you're going to fold it over again and you're going to press. Pressing helps. Now, if you like, if you sew, okay, what you can do is take this at that point to your sewing machine and you can stitch down one side and stitch down the other side. Okay, so you can do that if you want to sew it, just kind of like I did this one. Okay. But for this purpose of this video, because a lot of people who have asked me to do some no-sew projects. So get your glue. I always try to shake mine down. Shake your glue down. And take your glue. And you're going to take it. Let's see. I hope my fabric glue coming out. Let's see. Come on, fabric glue. Let's see. Let me get a pen sometimes. That's my dog. That's Kiko. He is like, okay, Kiko. He barking at somebody. It might be the mail lady. I don't know. I don't know. Okay, Kiko. 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 Shh. Kiko. He like, when he hears stuff outside, which is good, he'll bark. Tell you, got dogs have some good ears. All right, so sometimes I just have to take a pen and clean this out to get the glue started, because I don't know where my little cappy is, and I really want to invest in I'm gonna put a link down. I'm gonna invest in these little bottles that they have, and I know you all seen them with the little sharp little, look like little pen at the end. I think it actually keeps the glue, keeps everything real good. So I hate messing up a pen. But anyway, okay, so now you take this and you, okay, there we go. Put your glue on there. Uh-oh. Like so. Come on, glue. And this is just a, close these ends, and you know I also use, sometime I use that liquid stitch, because you can just use your iron with that. Oops, put it on, and it's really good too as well. That liquid stitch, I like that too. It's a permanent stitch, liquid, just liquid. But this fabric glue is really good too. Just make sure you get it all in there. This is a really good fabric glue. Now, the only thing that I won't probably have a link for is this fabric. I got this fabric when I was in New York. Remember I told you all before, I had gotten a lot of fabric when I was in New York. And a lot of this fabric comes, you know what? No. I didn't get this fabric in New York. Not this one. More of my African print fabrics I got in New York. You know what? I didn't get this in New York. That's not true. I got this at a fabric store. I don't remember which one. I'm sorry. I don't remember. But you know, Joanne Fabric sells some fabric, something like this too. So, check it out, because they have fabric like this. Okay, so you got that, like, see? So, really good. So the next thing you do, you just figure out what you're going to use. If you're going to use that, this particular, either a ring like this or this one. So actually, this one you can clip on a purse, or you can clip it on your key ring. You know, if you have keys, you can clip it on like that. Or if you use something like this, you can actually clip this onto your key ring. So, and it's up to you, because actually, you can actually, you know, hold this like that, you know, you can put it on your arm. You can actually make these large enough where it could fit around your wrist too as well. So it's totally up to you. You have to be creative with that. So at this point, we're going to figure out what we're going to use. So for the sake of this video, I think I'm going to use this one, since I've already used, the one like this. Excuse me. So now what we're going to do, since I'm using this ring here, We're going to take this, and you can use either one. It's up to you, but I'm going to use it for the sake of this video, this one. So now what we're going to do is we're going to put this piece together like this. So we're going to take it, take some glue. Oh, Lord. Come on, glue. Or if you were sewing, you would actually stitch across, okay? But for the sake of this one, no sew, we're going to stitch it. We're going to glue it. I'm so used to stitching everything. So we're going to put that like that. So our next step is to bring this ring up or whatever you're using, you know. Where we close it off at, we're going to pull it up like that. Because at this point, we're going to hide that. And so what you're going to do is you're going to need another piece of fabric. Okay. Not as large as this, but again, I'll have measurements below. And you're going to do the same thing that we did, except for you're only going to pull these two in the middle. And again, I'll have measurements for this. Okay. And we're going to take this piece, and this piece is actually the piece that we have wrapped here. So see, it doesn't have to be as thick as the piece I have here, but it's totally up to you. Again, it's your design, all right? So we're going to take it. We're going to take that piece of fabric. And we're going to put this in the middle, okay, like that. That's what we want to do. So what I'm going to do is take some glue. Oops. Jesus, I'm just dropping everything today. Take some glue. I mean to take it up that far. And bring this over to let it meet in the middle, okay? I didn't cut off any strings or anything that's in your way. That's gonna come up. So the next thing you're going to do is you're going to take a piece. You want this to meet in the middle. So because I want to tuck that piece under, what I'm going to do, and again, you do it however you want to. This is how I'm doing it for the sake of this video. So I'm gonna cut this piece. So at this point, this piece of fabric is, where's my? It's so funny, I can't never find anything sometimes. I'm like, where is my rulers? I don't have measuring tapes. This piece of fabric is almost 3 inches. So what you're going to do is take it, fold it over. You're gonna fold this in to make it a clean. It's gonna be clean so it could be clean clothes here, and then you're going to, what I would actually do is just put a little glue here. Close it in. This fold it over, and there you have it, and let it dry. So your next step, you can put either one or two of the embellishments on here. So I created these to put one there and one like right here, if I like, however I want to put them on there. You could use your hot glue gun, or you could use your I don't like how that looking. Let's see. Okay, so you could use your hot glue gun, or you can use your sorry. First of all, we got it on the wrong side. Bam, let's turn it over. Where we folded it here, that's where we're gonna put it, okay? Sorry about that, y'all. Where we folded it at, I got all enthused in these flowers. I'm like, oh, all engrossed, flowers, flowers. And so we're going to actually put that on this side. Now, as you notice, I don't have a little middle. So again, I showed you how to create the middle piece, or you can put a button. I couldn't even get it out. What's wrong with me today? A button, you can use a button or whatever you want to use here in the middle, okay? And that's how you create your key fob. And again, don't forget to add your little middle piece, your flower. Here, what you can do is actually, let's take this piece of fabric. If you forgot, or you can, like I said, you can add a button here. Listen, I know I got enough sleep. I don't know what's going on. I guess my mind too. I'm actually getting ready to do an event. I was asked to be a vendor, so I got, you know, stuff that I got to get together. So maybe that's it. I don't know. Who knows? I don't know. And even if you want to, you can take a button if you want to and cover a button with the fabric and put it in the middle, or you can make the circle like we made with the other pieces here. Let's do that. Actually, what I need right now is one of my wipes so that I could clean my hands with the glue. But you just take it. Let's see. You know, when you have fabric like this, it's hard to figure out which side is which. But take it, and here we go. And we start to figure out, show you this part again. Just in and out, all the way around. And I told you sometimes I stuff it with like the little pillow stuffing, or I just use my glue gun and just push it up. So I'll show you. Let me. And, you know, I just cut a little small piece. I'm not measuring it. I'm just cutting. I'm eyeballing, measuring, okay? And again, like I said, you'll get used to it. Let's see, this is kind of small. This is smaller than the ones I usually make. But also what I did, if you notice on this flower, I pulled the middle in. So all I did was stitch these together in the back to pull them together to close up that hole. Okay, so I did that a little different than I did the ones here. Remember, these were open and I just glued this piece, the middle piece in. So these two are a little different. So now that I have this, we're gonna close it off here. I'm still using that little needle. I don't know what I was thinking. Me and the little small needle. Okay. So I'm just gonna put it here in the middle like that. I already have my glue gun. Heating up. Oops. God, come on. I didn't really want that much glue, but I did, so. Okay, so then just put it in, and you can actually scrunch it up too, like this. Like I'm doing here, you can just scrunch it up with the hot glue, and then it make it a little larger in the middle, like that. Now, so when you get done, I'm up for this purpose of this video. I'm only gonna do one. And you know what? Sometimes you get glue around it. Just clean it off. You know, just clean it off. Okay. So we're going to put it here. And I'm going to use my glue gun, which is perfectly fine. Perfectly fine. I'm telling you, this hot glue is good. You know, it's and it lasts a long time. So, you know, depending on how you want to position it, we're going to position it there. And there you have it. Oh, back a little mat. And there you have it. Got a little glue right there, but we get it off. But there you have it. Just clean it off, and there you have your little fob. And again, like I said, depending on how you want to use it, you could use it as a wristlet. You could put it over, let's see, I got glue everywhere, y'all. And put it on your arm and hold whatever, your keys. You could add this to your keychain. Or again, you could have used this to put that on there and clip it to something. It's totally up to you. But I think those are really cute and handy. And so, yeah. So now I'm going to get back because this is the video for now. And I hope you enjoyed it. And I have more to come. So don't forget, if you haven't, subscribe to my YouTube channel. And I look forward to showing you more DIYs and a little bit of chit chat, and hopefully you'll see what I bring to my event, because I'm, you know, I'm doing a show, so I guess I'm excited about that, right? Again, if you don't want to make these, you can always go and get little embellishments to put on fabric. You just get your fabric and get it to match your embellishment. Matter of fact, here's one of the wallets that I created. And so what I'm going to do is, I don't know if I'm going to put this like this and add two. Forgot about that. I'm looking at, this is what I do here. I add these to my wallets that I make. So just to give it a little embellishment. People like embellishments. I don't know if I'm going to do one. And these are the wallets that I make. And it has for your checkbook and money. Here it has money, your credit cards, an ID, you know. These are the larger one, because I make a large one and I make a small one. The smaller one is, I should have had mine, because I wear it every day. People tend to really like these. These are the smaller ones. This one is a little smaller than that one. And same thing, you know, you have your for your money here. And for your ID, credit cards, and yeah, so. And it has a magnetic snap. And these are my little creations. All right. Well, thank you again for joining me. And thank you, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, you can use these for all types of embellishments. These embellishments for all types of projects. So I hope again that you enjoyed it, and I look forward to actually seeing what you make. I know sometimes people just don't share, but you know, if you like, you can. All right, talk to you soon. Oh, here's another one. Peace out. This is the one you saw in the video. All right, that I did the crossbody with, the no-sew. All right, talk to you soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.